Looking up there, this strange skies. Clouds are all trailing back there. Sort of like a formation, these bands. That's what they are. Wave barns. All over there. Trying to study these things. As opposed to posting work. That's why I'm just putting these uploads. Barney flowers in there. Yeah, trying to make an understanding, trying to come to some conclusion as to what they are, the events we're seeing, images in the sky, images in the space, other researchers putting these things up, Celtic Watcher looking at his work, looking at them, and it's constancy. I see things and I don't see things, you know, just when I'm walking about, 1 minute there's a bird there, same second it's gone. I'm trying to capture them. It's difficult. Anyhow, getting back to what I was chatting about, these things in the sky, you know, the images, and Son of Man and godly type things. I'm seeing these things in the clouds up there in the daytime, you know, when you adjust and alter contrast, brightness, etc. And there's other people, like Celtic Watcher, he's seeing these things at nighttime up there. Which makes me start to think that these things are there all the time. You know how you look up at the clouds and you'll see, for instance, back there, in between there, you'll see a brightness. I mean, that's not the sun. I mean, the sun's over that way. But an energy point. And these things are visible at night time. If we're talking image that's captured by standard cameras, day or night, it's telling me something, that these things are there. There's constancy. So this fractal identity, that's what it is. Fractals are energy. Man, do the research on that. I don't have my notes in front of me, but I could go at great length to try to explain myself further. But on the basis and understanding that these things are there day or night, I mean, because daytime becomes nighttime, and we can see these cloud formations during the day, and make of them what we will, tag them for whatever you want to put on them, they're there at nighttime also. As I say, I'm trying to study these things, and I look at these things, I see structure, buildings, focal points, energy points. It's part of reality. We don't understand these things. Science, the boys in control, they're not going to tell us these things. If they did that, they'd lose control. So that's hushed, kept secret. And because they control everything, media especially, all the establishments, all the learning academies, they control everything. We're always going to remain in the dark. So we have to find these things out for ourselves. I mean, look at that. It's like cotton wool buds up there. I mean, that's a real plane. Yeah, it's like cotton wool buds up there. And it's moving. Maybe that's the universe showing us things in plain sight. Yeah, look and learn. As opposed to listening to bullshit. Yeah. I've established in my own mind that these images I'm looking at, it's a map of the heavens, it's a map of the universe, it's an as above, so below, it's very same, similar. You can capture these images when looking at Google Earth, you know, you can isolate an area, zoom in on it, and you can see the same type of structure down here in the Earth plane as what you are up there. Well, the images that I'm showing you. I can only go on that, I can only comment on that in this, and have some sort of authority on what I'm talking about, for the simple fact I study these things in greater detail than anybody. I've got the original data, I look at it, I look at it at a microscopic level. Everything correlates, everything. Colours, shapes, more especially the colours. The colours are a constancy, wherever I go, how far out I go, whatever photograph I care to study, be it Mars, the Moon, Pluto, Uranus, all these places. I mean, you people that are coming to the page, you can identify with the skills I've got, and I look at these things, and it's a constancy, it's the same. Wherever I go, wherever, whether you want to go into the center of the galaxy, or you want to go up to Orion, a lot of people believe that to be the base camp, the nucleus, the nebula, or the universe, our galaxy. And there's lots of people that are trying to show you these things, and they're not being very successful. I've seen these things years ago. I know what's up there, I know what's out there, and it's a foundation stone of our reality, our universe. Man is king. And that's a fact. I'm not going to want to release these things or my findings to anybody. I keep them to myself. I don't want to cause a ruckus amongst people. I mean, you can believe what you like. I mean, what I'm putting over here and what I'm trying to say is subjective on my part. It's not it's saying that it's factual. It's an idea. It's an ology. That's how I put it, an ology. An ology of thought. I can't put a name to it. What do you want to call it? Spiritualology or extraterrestrialology, interdimensionalology. Anology. Anology is a concept. It's an idea. Nothing else. It's just a thought process. My thoughts. Whether you agree with them, whether you don't, I mean, that's I don't have a problem with that. I mean, you've got a right to believe what you want to believe. What you think. That's the only way we're going to come to some conclusion as to what we're seeing. I don't believe it, we'll ever find out. However, it's fun trying to establish something. Something up there, out there, something that exists. I mean, anybody who's of the opinion there's nothing up on the moon, there's nothing up on Mars, there's nothing up on Venus, there's nothing up on Saturn, it's quite frankly got their head up their arse. I've seen these things, I know they're there. And the sooner people start to believe and waking up, we're not alone in this world, then we might start to get answers. The controllers down here are not telling us anything, and they never will. It's always going to be like that. So we have to start, like I said in the last upload, we start ignoring them. Just ignore them. I mean, they're just lying. They're just a shower of liars. For this, You go to government, you go to any government in this world, the control mechanism, a lot of people say it's pyramid. Yeah, there's a pyramid in every society. Whether it's in Europe, whether it's in America, whether it's in Australia, whether it's in Russia, it's the pyramid of control. And the powers that be all read from the same page. It's a script. Some folks would put it out, well, what's in vogue just now is Antichrist. I mean, you gotta understand what an Antichrist is. Antichrist? What is an Antichrist? A lot of people are waiting for some individual someplace. Some king, some queen, some president, some governor, some politician, some war leader, some tribal leader to step into the fray. Oh, that's the Antichrist. Antichrist is a system of belief, a structure that's trying to be put in place by people that try and control this world. Are controlling, they're not trying, up to now they're controlling this world. And Antichrist is what it is. Anti-Christ, anti-consciousness. Christ is consciousness. It's no nailed down to one person called Jesus, whether it be Confucius, whether it be Zoroaster or Mithras, Allah, Buddha. It's none of them, it's all of them, every one of them. Antichrist? Forget it. Stop being silly. Antichrist doesn't exist as an individual. It's a system. You know what they're into? They're into their satanic worship. They worship Lucifer. I mean, I'm not wanting to give you a fucking history lesson on conspiracy theories or things that are factual as opposed to superstition. It's actual. It's happening in this world. Whether you believe it or whether you don't, the people in control of this world believe in what they're trying to put across. It's almost to the point where the people that control this system, the guys, these megalomaniacs that are the bankers, I mean, the top of the tree guy, the Rothschilds, people like Queen or whatever the fuck. I mean, it's not important. These people have got to the point where they've got so much money, they don't care anymore. So they've adopted this system. A megalomania, yeah, psychopathic control. We'll worship Satan. Oh, this goody-goody gets you nowhere. Let's promote evil. Let's promote badness. And that's the norm. That's the everyday thought of everybody, and it's a fucking disease. It's a viral thing, and the powers that be, the guys at this imaginary pyramid that these people adopted, they don't know anything about that. I mean, the pyramid, showing you where the pyramids are, they're fucking everywhere. They're down here, they're up there, they're on the moon, they're on Mars, they're everywhere in the universe. They're actually in the central part of heaven, the nebula, the Milky Way. They're there. All easily seen if you've got the wherewithal to find them. And this is probably a rant on my part. It's probably frustration. Frustration that the majority of people, outside of the people that come on this page, totally poo-poo everything that we are thinking or what we're saying or what we're promoting. In time, they'll embrace everything that we say. And history? History's for losers. That's a fucking lie. Everything they tell you is a lie. The whole concept of what's written inside a page, fucking lie, it's imagination. Yeah. You try and promote truth, you try and spout up about truth, you try and say anything outside the norm, no chance. Universe is controlled by megalomaniacs, madmen at the helm, and they're leading us into a path of destruction. Tells you that in the book, I'd go with that book. Yeah, a lot of that's written inside that book, it's true. It's prophecy. Because the people that created that book, the guys way up there, they knew the fickleness, the fragility of the human mind. They knew it was only a matter of time before they would self-destruct. And we're in that time. We're in the end times. We're at that point where the universe may just have to step in and switch the lights, switch them off. 3 days of darkness. Three is an interesting number. And 3 days of darkness? Think about it. It might not be literally 3 days of boop, the lights go off, the sun goes out, which that is possible. I've seen that. blank. It's just a blank. It's unrecognizable. The human eye can't pick these things up. But let's imagine for a moment that 3 days of darkness means, oh yeah, a solar pulse where they just turn down all the communications, just close them down. Everything. Nothing works anymore. You get up in the morning, sun will still be there, but there isn't any communication. Nothing. Nothing works. You can't go anywhere. There isn't any power. There isn't any communication. None of this daily Facebook, huh? None of that. You get up, switch on your computer, nothing. Press the button, nothing. You look outside, everything's normal. However, there's a quiet, there's a calm. Just maybe people in the distance mumbling and chatting. And you go outside and you find that people's cars will not start. Our computers. Petrol pumps will not start. Hello. Nobody's going anyplace. Darkness. No communication. Nobody knows what's going on. And the powers that be, the banking system, commerce, everything comes to a grinding halt. 3 days of darkness. That's the darkness. And people will start to ask questions. What do you think is what's going on? And the only people, in my mind, that'll be able to come up with some form of answer would be you. Because you're clever. You've studied these things. It's like I'm studying these things there. Yep, 3 days of darkness. I mean, there might be physical darkness. Sun might just blink out. Plunge everybody in a stone age. If you haven't got a candle or some forms of power, torch or kerosene lamp, paraffin lamp, whatever. If you haven't got one of them, you're fucked. Everything. All your food, fridge, all closed down. Everything. Remember, we're talking no power, no communication. You ain't going everywhere. You're not going anywhere. Everywhere. When you're all the darkness will be everywhere. They're here. To where she is. She's 20 feet. I wouldn't be able to see her. You wouldn't be able to see. You'd be faking around with a match or a lighter. Yeah. See, cheers for the smokers. They'd be safe for a wee while until their gas runs out. And you'd be looking around. You'll not see anything. You'll not want to go anywhere. The only way of looking and seeing things be able to speak to people without being frightened would be lighting a fire. Maybe on that mound there, maybe it'd be a bonfire, a ceremonial bonfire, and people might be attracted to it. Yeah, and sit around and talk in darkness, no light. And the stars fell down for the sky like a scroll. Yeah, just been rolled up. Interesting. You don't believe in these things. It's entirely up to you. But it was GBG. I remember he put up this video and he had the camera pointed at the sun and the sun blinked. The sun went out. Went back on again. There are space beings, our brothers up there, are probably thinking, like, we're going to have to do something here, step in. And maybe it's time. Maybe it's time for a prophecy, the end times prophecy to come through. Jesus coming in the clouds. Well, I mean, I looked up there and I never really noticed it until I uploaded the video and I seen what I seen and I thought, hang on a second. Well, he's not actually got a t-shirt on saying I am Jesus, so that would be subjective on my part. I like to refer to it as the Son of Man, a manly figure, had a moustache and a beard, godly up there, just over there it was. And I'm a bit done on this topic. I haven't missed anything outside of the fact that whether you believe, whether you disbelieve, the fact of the exercise is this. The people that are in control of this world, they believe it. They believe it. And, well, anyhow, I'm done. But I say this. I keep trying to remember this for myself. And keep the faith. And faith in whatever you believe in. And more importantly, keep the faith in yourself. Never mind listening to what anybody tells you. That includes me. I mean, I'm running off at the mouth here. You're talking to, or you're listening to somebody that's got a well-oiled tongue. And I could be way, way far off the mark. Although I don't think that. Not truly, and I don't suppose you do either. I mean, there's too much going on. There's too much that's went on to believe otherwise.